Hi, welcome to our math. Today I'm doing a series of videos on exponents. Now this video is a little bit different because all of my exponents, or most of them, are fractions. And fractional exponents are out there. There will be videos about what they are, but for now, realize the whole point of this is just to show you that the rules don't change. So when you have four H's that are all multiplied together with exponents, you just add your exponents. Now I'm gonna pull the exponents out so I can have a little bit more room. I have 1 + 3/4 minus 1/4 plus 5/2. You have to remember there's a 1 there. Okay. So this is, I'm gonna turn this 1 into 4/4. I'm gonna turn this 5/2 into 10/4. So I'm gonna multiply a 2 to numerator and denominator to get an equivalent fraction. So I'm gonna turn this into 10/4. And then I'm gonna start adding 4, 7, 6, 16/4. 16/4 = 4. So my numerator becomes h^4. Okay. Next, for my denominator, I have -3/4 plus 1/2 plus 1/4. Well, once again, to be able to add my fractions, I need common denominators. So to get this 2 to be a 4, I need to multiply numerator and denominator by 1/2. This is also like pizza math. You cut it in half, cut in half again, you have 4 pieces. So half your pizza is 2/4. 2/4. So now I add just the numerators, -3 + 2 + 1. So -3 + 2 = -1, 1 + 1 = 0. This is not a denominator of 0. You can't have a 0 in the denominator of a fraction. It's not allowed. It's an undefined concept. It's something that's studied a lot in higher math classes. But this isn't a 0, it's h^0. And if an exponent is a counter, basically, we're saying there are none of them. The other way you can think of this is anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1. The reason that anything to the power of 0 is 1 is because if you think of h^2 / h^2, we know that equals 1. But with this whole subtraction rule, h^2 - 2 is equal to h^0, which is equal to 1. So you can see a zero exponent is basically going back to your multiplicative identity, and the multiplicative identity is 1. So anything to the power of 0 is 1. So this denominator is just 1, so my answer is going to be h^4. Okay, for my next example, it's a little bit simpler. There's no major fraction. Here is the areas where students make mistakes. First of all, when you have a number in the exponent, oftentimes students don't give that number the exponent. But this exponent needs to distribute in to both bases. And once again, it can only distribute in because the parentheses are free of addition or subtraction. If there was any addition or subtraction, we wouldn't be able to do that distribution. Okay, so this is really -5/4. a^3/4 × 4. So there's a lot of areas to make a mistake on this problem. First of all, it's -5/4. -5 × -5 = +, −-5 = -, −-5 = +. So the first thing we have to remember is that our answer is positive. The next thing we need to do is actually take 5^4. Well, 5^4 = 625. The next problem I see is a lot of students multiply that 4 to top and bottom, or worse, they take the numerator and denominator and take it to the power of 4. Don't take an exponent to an exponent. You're asking for trouble there. We're just doing basic multiplication. And if you can't remember how to multiply a fraction to an integer, make your integer a fraction. So I put this 4/1, then you multiply your numerators and denominators. But the genius here is these 4s can divide before you multiply, because as long as everything is in the world of multiplication and division, you can shift your order about a little bit. So I can look at those two fractions, divide and reduce before I multiply, and now I have 3 times 1 divided by 1 times 1, which is just a cubed. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. I'll see you on the next video. Thanks!